Hi, very good morning. I'm Dr. Janak Patel. I'm an MD physician. I'm still a student. I'm learning every day. Whatever I've gathered from internet, from different websites, I'm sharing with you. Today we'll be talking on what we call as puberty. This is quite important because there are a lot of disorders which can occur at puberty. So we'll be trying to explain you in a very simplified form. Definition, physiology, disorders, and some of the investigation to confirm that what are the disorders. So puberty is a physiological transition which takes place from childhood to the reproductive maturity. So once the puberty starts, that particular person is able to have reproductive maturity, and it is associated with a growth spurt, appearance of both primary and secondary sexual character, and usually in female it is between 8 to 14 years. If it occurs before 8, it is called pre-puberty or precocious puberty, and if it occurs after 14 years of age, we call delayed puberty. Same way in male, before 9 and after 14. So in a male between 9 to 14 and in a female between 8 to 14. There are a few words we already told you. Pre-puberty means before the puberty starts. Puberty means usually it will start between 8 to 14 in female and 9 to 14 in boys. There are other words which are used. Adrenarche or gonadarche or pubarche. Then they also use a word telarche, menarche in female particularly. If it is after 14 years, delayed puberty. If it before 8 and 9 in respective female and male, precocious puberty. And if it doesn't have full development of primary and secondary sex character, we call incomplete precocious puberty. So these are some of the words which are being utilized, and we'll be using those particular words in this chapter. So there is different phases in puberty. One is called adrenarche, meaning there is a maturation of a cortex of adrenal gland, and then it starts secretion of androgen secretions, and androgen secretions increases. Then we call that as adrenarche. Once there is a change in the gonads, earliest gonadal changes, ovaries and testes starts becoming bigger in size to grow, and they start producing sex hormone, then we call that as a gonadarche. In female, when you start getting secondary sex character in the form of a breast development, usually noticed as a firm, tender lump directly in the center under the nipple, that is papilla and areola. This is called as a breast bud. Then we call as telarche. Once there is an appearance of a pubic hair, we call pubarche. And this is because of the increased level of androgens from adrenal glands and testes. First menstrual bleeding which starts, then we call menarche, and now chances of fertility starts. For menarche, you require gonadotropic releasing hormone from hypothalamus, which should stimulate pituitary to produce FSH-LH, which will stimulate ovary to produce estrogen and progesterone, and that should be a normal outflow tracks. Then menarche will start. So this is the minimal requirement for menarche to start. So There are four stages: menarche, adrenarche, spimarche, and gonadarche. In male, ejaculation, first ejaculation of semen is called spimarche. So these are the different stages. We already explained you that development of the breast called telarche, development of the secondary sexual characters, particularly pubic hair, because of endogenous effects, we call pubarche, and first menstrual cycle starts, onsets of menses, that is called menarche, and first appearance of spermatozoa in a seminal fluid, we call spermarche. So these are the different words which are being utilized in different phases of puberty. So during puberty, you start getting physical changes like body size, body proportion, development of a primary sex character and secondary sex character. So that occurs during puberty period. This is in a female, what changes takes place. Year preceding the menarche, approximately 3 inches changes in height, and totally 5 to 6 inches increases during entire puberty. During 2 years preceding menarche, there is increase in 2.5 inches per year, total is 5.5 inches. And after menarche, the growth becomes slow, it is 1 inch per year, and around 18, the growth comes to standstill in a female, while in a male, it will continue further longer. In a boys, there's a rapid growth, almost it is 12.8. End of this puberty, almost 15.3 inches, and peak is 14. After puberty, there is a slight deceleration, but still the growth continues till the age of 20 to 21 in male. In a male, there are pronounced body hair changes in the form of beard, mustache, hair on the chest. Usually they are more coarse. The muscle starts becoming bulkier, heavier musculature. Angular features like square jaw, triangular or triangular in the mid region, narrow hip, pectoralis development, less fat tissue overall, deepening of the voice, etc. While in a female, lighter musculature, pronounced body hair characteristic mainly in the pubic region, hair all over is usually finer, there's a round features, softer facial features, hourglass mid region, hip becomes wider, there's a pronounced breast tissue development, more fat tissue all over and higher voice. By and large, the physiological phase of puberty is lasting for 2 to 5 years, during which the genital organs starts maturing. Puberty is an overlapping period. It is from end of childhood to the beginning of adolescence. Child that are not yet sexually matured, we call pubescents. So in a pubescent child, there is no maturity of a sexual characters. It is lasting from 2 years to 4 years, we say 5 years. Children who has got less than 2 years, 2 years or less than 2 years, they rapidly mature, and the person who takes more than 3 to 4 years for complete transformation into an adult, then we call it a slow matures. So puberty will be divided into two different stages, pre-pubescent and pubescent stage. Pre-pubescent stage overlaps the closing of two closing years or two of a childhood. So it is the end of a childhood, which may be 1 or 2 years, and one who no longer be a child but not yet adolescent. And secondary sex character begins to appear, but reproductive organs are yet not fully developed. And in a pubescent stage, now there is a dividing line between childhood and adolescence. The secondary sex characters starts getting fully developed and sexual maturation appears. And secondary sex character, we have told you that it continues to develop, and there is a full development of sex organs. Post-pubertal is a stage which overlaps a few years of adolescence. One first year or 2 years of adolescence, where secondary sex character becomes well developed and sex organ begins to function in a mature manner. So puberty is a time of rapid growth and changes. And in a girl, peak is 12 to 12.5 and in boys 15.5. So puberty growth will be maximum between 8.5 to 11.5 in girl and 10.5 to 14.5 in a male. Late puberty period means if it starts between age of 8 to 11, it is a late prepubertal period. And in that, adrenal cortex will now start secreting dehydroepiandrosterone, and androgen will result into adrenarche or pubarche. Delayed puberty means the breast development takes after 13 years, lack of pubic hair by age of 14 years, and failure to menstruate by the age of 15 to 16 years. So when there is a delay in breast development, delay in the pubic hair growth and menstrual cycle by the age of 15 to 16, we call delayed puberty. While in a boys, lack of testicular enlargement by the age of 14, lack of pubic hair by the age of 15, and more than 5 years to complete the genital organ enlargement, then we call that as a delayed puberty. Precocious puberty means it occurs early. Precocious puberty is defined as a onset of secondary sexual characters in a female before the age of 8 years and in a boy before the age of 9 years. If you start getting those particular characteristics. But incomplete precocious puberty means isolated manifestation of precocity without development of other signs of puberty. So you don't have a full puberty signs in the form of a full development of the breast tissue, pubic hairs, voice deepening, etc. We call incomplete precocious puberty, which can be divided into three depending upon telarche, pubarche and menarche. So if there is a premature telarche, premature pubarche, premature menarche, but there is no full development of signs of puberty, then we call it an incomplete precocious puberty. Now for this particular thing, puberty development, you require a hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis to work normally. Means hypothalamus should produce gonadotropic releasing factor, which will stimulate pituitary gland to release FSH LH. That LH will be acting on the testis and ovary to develop completely. You will have ovulation and you will have a spermatogenesis. And FSH, they will start releasing, stimulates this particular testis to release testosterone, while ovary will start releasing estrogen and progesterone. They will also release a substance called as an inhibin, and that inhibin will inhibit FSH. While testosterone, testis which releases inhibin, will inhibit FSH. So this will be the hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis. And also testosterone can directly inhibit release of gonadotropic releasing hormone, and estrogen will have a stimulatory effect on hypothalamus. So that is how it is working. and estrogen will also stimulate the pituitary gland. While testosterone will inhibit at the level of pituitary to release FSH, LH, excess of testosterone. So that particular we have already explained, gonadotropic releasing hormone acting on pituitary, FSH, LH release, this is the effect on ovary. It will produce estrogen, progesterone, and there is also release of inhibin, and that inhibin can inhibit pituitary FSH, and estrogen will stimulate positive feedback phase on a hypothalamus and negative feedback during a luteal phase, while testosterone, that is testosterone or dehydrotestosterone, and release of estrogen will have effect on testes, and inhibin will inhibit at the level of pituitary to inhibit the FSH production, while testosterone has also got inhibition of gonadotropic releasing hormone. Same thing shown here. So there are some of the factors which will stimulate the hypothalamus to release gonadotropic releasing hormone and further release of FSH-LH, which will act on testes and ovary. Now, initiation of puberty will depend upon genetic factor, nutritional factors, maturation of hypothalamus, neurotransmitters, adrenal androgen activities, exercise, psychological factors, etc. So these are all the factors which will take part during puberty development. One of the genetic factor is Y chromosomes. This Y chromosome will take part in differentiation into testicular differentiation. So it will convert Leydig cell to produce testosterone and Sertoli cells to produce sperms, and there will be production of testosterone from testes and sperms from Sertoli cells. So it will stimulate Leydig cells and Sertoli cells development. During primary sex character development, there's a development of the penile structures, vagina, fallopian tubes, uterus, testes, prostate glands, etc. And in secondary sex character, voice, body shape, shoulder, hip, facial and body hair, breast tissue, Adam apple, etc. So depending upon the age timelines, now the person will be differentiated into male and female, depending upon X chromosome and Y chromosomes. This is axillary hair, this is chest hair, this is pubic hair. So there will be deepening of this particular depending upon the chromosomes. Even a development of the acne will depend upon the secretion of androgens. So if androgen secretion is more than estrogen, you will have acne formation. Even the secretion of from sebaceous glands will produce a typical body odor. Voice deepening, Adam apple appearance, etc. And even erections that will take place during puberty. These are the different types of hair development and different enlargement, secondary sex character, because the size of the penile structure, testicular size, penile structures, and we call as a hair growths. Event of puberty will be depending upon these different hormones, GnRH, FSH-LH, and estrogen progesterone in a female. And you will have a development of what we call as a menarche if there is a normal outflow tract. So for puberty in a female, you require a menarche development appearance of secondary sex character and physical development and psychological development. So development of the breast tissue, development of the pubic and axillary hair, as well as the voice character changes, etc. This is telarche breast development, for which you require estrogen, and for pubic hair, pubarche, adrenarche, you require androgens. And then you require a secondary sex character to be developed, that is development of labia, then what we call as a development of vagina, uterus, ovary, etc. You require estrogens. Then female voice becomes deeper. They start having menstrual cycle, we call menarche. Subcutaneous tissue also increases, and then you get full development of secondary sex character, and sexual organs also gets fully developed. These are all the changes. We already told you that penile and testicular sizes will increase. Nocturnal emesis is called the wet dreams, and when there is nocturnal emesis, there is also what we call as a erectile functions. And puberty will end between 18 to 20 years. But in a male, often it gets full facial hair until the age of 25. And during night, you can have a sexual awakening. As far as disorder is concerned, you can have a precocious puberty, means signs of full development of secondary sex character as well as development of the sex organs before the beginning of puberty, that is 8 in female and 9 in male. But if it is delayed after the age of 14 and 15 in male, we call delayed puberty, there can be a growth problems during adolescent, like short stature, tall stature, marked obesity, menstrual disorders, etc. These are called growth development problems. And you can have also dyschronos, or timing of the progression. These are the different types of disorders you can come across during puberty. Early or precocious puberty, delayed puberty, or because of abnormality in X and Y chromosome, it can be intersexual, or we call it a heterosexual. Or dyssynchronous means timing of the progression can be abnormal. So precocious puberty, delayed puberty, physical changes which do not develop by menarche after appropriate interval, we call dyssynchronous. You can have a heterosexual changes because of abnormal gene, that is X and Y chromosomes. And timing of progression of the pubertal changes can be abnormal. Complete puberty, there is a central causes, peripheral causes. Central causes are called gonadotropin dependent puberty, GDPP, gonadotropic dependent puberty. And peripheral is gonadotropic independent puberty. While incomplete can be premature telarche, pubarche, and menarche. So it can be classified into complete and incomplete. Precocious puberty you can divide, we have already told you, central and peripheral. no CNS lesion, there is no damage to central part. It can be idiopathic, it can be genetic, or it can be because of severe hypothyroidism, etc. But because of CNS lesion, very commonly because of damage to hypothalamus or pituitary, or because post radiation or disease like hydrocephalus, cyst, trauma, CNS inflammation or surgery, etc. Some of the causes as far as peripheral is concerned, ovarian cyst, ovarian tumors, granulosa theca cell tumors, etc., which can lead to poor development of ovary and incomplete secretion of ovarian hormones. In both boys and girls, exogenous estrogen, adrenals, androgen secreting tumors like congenital adrenal hyperplasia, some of the teratomas. There is one called as a McCune-Albright syndrome, which is a genetic disorder, autosomal dominant. In this also you can have abnormal production of hormones. There can be one variety we call as a functional, where there is a temporary delay in puberty. That are functional disorders, most commonly constitutional delay of the growth and puberty, which can be because of low FSH LH or low testosterone or estrogens, combination of these two, low level of FSH LH and low level of testosterone or estrogen, and that can produce little of delayed puberty. Hypogonadotropic hypogonadism means there is a decreased production of gonadotropic hormones, which results into hypogonadism. And secondary to hypogonadism, now there is an abnormality in puberty. And this will be very commonly because of either pituitary or hypothalamic failure. We call hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis failure. And in that condition, there will be low LH-FSH and low testosterone estrogen level. There will be also one variety where you will have a normal or increased level of gonadotropic hormones, but there is a hypogonadism, which is because of primary failure of gonads, that is either ovary or testis. Hence, there is no negative feedback. So there is an increased production of gonadotropic releasing hormone, and there is an increased production of FSH-LH. So high level of FSH-LH, but because of a gonad failure, low level of testis, low level of testosterone because of a testis abnormality, and low level of estrogen because of ovarian abnormality. So it can be normal, it can be primary failure, secondary failure. Secondary failure is because of hypogonadism, where it is secondary because of decreased production of gonadotropic releasing factor or FSH-LH from pituitary. So this is called secondary hypogonadism, and this is failure of gonads itself, and this will result into increased production of FSH-LH, and that will be what we call as primary failure of testis. This is secondary failure of testis, secondary due to hypothalamus or secondary due to pituitary gland. These are functional causes: chronic renal disease, chronic congestive cardiac failure, gastrointestinal disease, malnutrition, sickle cell, iron overload, hemochromatosis, COPD, cystic fibrosis, bronchial asthma, anorexia nervosa, bulimia, psychogenic conditions, extreme exercise, etc. These are all the chronic conditions which can result into decreased production of gonadotropic hormones, gonadotropic releasing factor, as well as FSH-LH. In also poorly controlled diabetes mellitus, hypothyroidism, Cushing disease, hyperprolactinemia, PCOS, etc. also, you can have a decreased production of gonadal hormones. and even in AIDS and recurrent infection involving testes or ovary, as well as some of the drugs, can also lead to what we call as hypogonadism. We already mentioned regarding hypogonadotropics. These are all the different conditions. Do remember Kallmann syndromes. And there's also one condition called as idiopathic hypogonadotropic hypogonadism, which is genetic in etiology. And there is another condition where you can have idiopathic hypergonadotropic hypogonadism, which is associated with obesity. This is some of the conditions. This is again one variety of a genetic mutation, adrenal hyperplasia congenita. So this is one of that. So these are some of the congenital conditions. You can have other syndromes like Prader-Willi, Noonan's, Chart syndrome, Bardet-Biedl syndromes, etc. But most common is Kallmann syndrome among all those. Among acquired condition, we already told you CNS damage like craniopharyngioma or germinomas, hypothalamic gliomas, optic nerve gliomas, pituitary tumors, surgery, trauma, pituitary apoplexy, Simons or Sehan syndromes, infiltration of pituitary, hypophysitis, very commonly because of sarcoidosis, infections like meningoencephalitis, radiotherapy, all this can produce damage to central axis. That is, we call a hypothalamic pituitary gonadal axis can be damaged. In a female, Turner syndrome, Swire syndrome, mixed gonadal dysgenesis where you get double X or XY, pure ovarian agenesis where you get double X, galactosemia, FSH-LH receptor gene mutation, steroidogenic defects, and in a boys, like mixed gonadal dysgenesis, testicular dysgenesis, Klinefelter syndrome, Noonan syndromes, androgen resistance, steroid genetic defects, etc. These are hypergonadotropic because of primary damage to ovary, primary damage to testes. Some of those remains common. We call it as a radiation, chemotherapy, trauma, infection, autoimmunity, idiopathic. While here, same, radiation, chemotherapy, trauma, surgery, infection. There is one condition called as a vanishing testis, certain toxins, all these conditions. Even drugs you can put. These are some of the clinical features of delayed puberty. Secondary sex character do not develop by the age of 14 years. And in a female, no menstruation till the age of 60. You will call that as a delayed puberty. So in a delayed puberty, in a female, you will have a breast bud does not appear properly till age of 13. Menarche does not occur till the age of 16. And there is a delayed progression. Menarche does not occur within 5 years after the breast bud development. That we call as a delayed puberty. This is in a girl, this is in a boy. We have already mentioned that breast development lacks by the age of 13. And within 5 years, there is no full development of the breast and menstrual period. There's a lack of pubic hair development by the age of 14, and female do not menstruate by the age of 15 to 16. In a boy's, testicular enlargement does not take place by age of 14, lack of pubic hair by 16, and more than 5 years to complete genital enlargement. Then we call that as a delayed puberty. Or sometimes the word utilizes pubertal arrest. Some of the etiology for delayed puberty, we already told you, constitutional hypergonadotropic hypogonadism and hypogonadotropic hypogonadism. This is primary failure of organs, we call sex organs, and this is failure of hypothalamic pituitary axis. Classical example, Kallmann syndrome, anorexia nervosa. There is also one condition we call as a normal gonadotropic hypogonadism, which can be also there like in a PCOS or villularizing tumors of ovary or ovarian adrenal tumors, etc. Or it can be because of endocrine or non-endocrine like malnutrition. Investigation is mainly family history and good clinical examination. Proper examination of external genitals and secondary sex characters becomes very, very important. As far as laboratory investigation is concerned, to differentiate between hypergonadotropic and hypo, FSH LH level is very important. If they are low, they are hypogonadotropic, hypogonadism. And if they are elevated, hypergonadotropic, hypogonadism. Also, the level of testosterone, level of estrogen, progesterone is also important. And level of 17 hydroxy deficiency becomes very important to find out congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Chromosomal study is also important. Radiological study to confirm the bony age and also to find out pituitary and hypothalamic disorders. You can go for CT and MRI. So these are all the different tests which you can go for. You can go for chromosomal studies. There is similar way, there is one word we call as a precocious puberty. So if secondary sexual character occurs before the age of 8 in female and before the age of 9 in male, we call as a precocious puberty. This is a typical appearance. You can divide into three varieties: true precocious puberty, pseudo, or we call the false, and incomplete. There is also one word utilized is isosexual or heterosexual. Now, just little word regarding a true means you have got a classical all finding of precocious puberty means you have got a development of the primary sexual organs and secondary sex character before the age of 8 in female and before the age of 9 in male. In a pseudo, there are few characters which develops, but basically the person has got a development of a secondary sex character and the sex organs are developed normally. While in incomplete, the secondary sex characters are delayed, but sex organs are developed. In an isosexual variety, feminizing sign appears in girl and masculinization signs will appear in a boy. So you have got what we call a secondary sex character develops fully in a person. So that is called isosexual. But if there is a development of masculinization character in a female and feminizing character in a male, then we call it a heterosexual. Means a boy will have a both character, development of the sex organs plus feminization, and female will have a development of muscular body. So secondary sex character will appear like a male, but there is a development of secondary sex characters which is like a male, but sex organs are developed. So that is called as a heterosexual. So true variety, which can be central or cerebral, it is because of increased production of a pituitary gonadotropic hormones. The most common cause, 80 to 90% of the time, it is idiopathic. It can be because of CNS tumors. Gonadotropic releasing hormones is released. These are all the different types of tumor which can give rise to in CNS tumor. Hypothalamic or pituitary gland tumors, optic gliomas, craniopharyngiomas, germinomas, ganglioneuromas, etc. Some of the CNS dysfunction, hydrocephalus, irradiation, trauma, infection, congenital abnormalities, congenital adrenal hyperplasia, etc. So these are all the causes of what we call as true variety, or we call central causes or pituitary or maybe hypothalamus. While a false or peripheral precocious puberty is because of increased secretion of sex hormones like estrogen or androgens, where estrogen and androgen production is by sexual organs and it is not dependent on pituitary gonadotropin. This we call as a false precocious puberty, where sex organs are fully developed, they are overproducing hormones, and you have got a precocious puberty. Means now you start developing a secondary sex characters. So false puberty, false precocious puberty can be isosexual or heterosexual. We already explained. If there is no secondary sex character development like masculinization in a female, it is isosexual. But if there is a masculinization in a female and feminization in a male, then it becomes heterosexual. So girls who has got feminization early is isosexual. But if there is a virilization or masculinization, we call it a female pseudo hermaphrodite, or we call female heterosexual. We already explained incomplete precocious puberty, meaning only one pubertal changes as breast development takes place before the age of 8 years, but there is absence of development of other puberty changes like pubic hairs, etc., menarche, etc. So this is idiopathic central precocious puberty. So in an incomplete precocious puberty, there is a premature telarche, means breast tissue develops, premature pubarche, premature adrenarche appears. So there is an appearance of all this. But puberty develops early, but there is no menarche. There is no menarche. So there is no menstruation. Investigation, we already told you that to find out whether it is primary or secondary. In primary variety, there is a failure of testes and ovary to produce testosterone and estrogen. And because of no negative feedback, there is increased level of FSH-LH. So that easily identifies whether it is primary or secondary. If there is secondary, then there is a decreased production of FSH-LH, either because of hypothalamus or because of pituitary gland etiology. Also, there will be decreased level of testosterone and estrogens. So that will help you to identify very easily. In some of the conditions, you can have an abnormal production of prolactin, we call as a hyperprolactinemia, in which the prolactin level will be elevated. You can also have estimation of adrenal androgens like dehydroepiandrosterone, and you can do a urinary level also. In some of the endocrine disorders like thyroid hypothyroidism, Cushing syndrome, etc., also you can have an abnormality in the puberties. Also in case of a chronic disease like chronic liver disease, chronic renal disease, also GI tract disorders, you can have abnormal puberty. To confirm that, you can go for a bony age by taking a bone x-rays, ultrasound, CT, MRI to rule out a pituitary or hypothalamic etiology. You can, if you want to prove that there is decreased production of GnRH, you can go for GnRH stimulation test. As soon as you give that, there is an increased production of FSH-LH. if there is no pituitary failure. So these are all the things which can be done to find out whether it is primary, secondary, and what is the basic etiology. So these are all the slides which you can go through at your leisure time. So this is GnRH stimulation test, and you can look for FSH, LH production, whether it increases or decreases. Bony age, CT MRI for hypothalamic or pituitary etiology. Ultrasound for adrenal ovary, testes, also for uterus. You can have a vaginal examination, vaginal smear for pycnotic index, etc. You can go for a ultrasound for ovarian tumors, cyst, testicular tumors. MRI CT can be also utilized for adrenal gland tumors. We already told you X-rays for bony age, brain MRI to rule out hypothalamic and pituitary etiology. These are all the investigation we have told you to rule out true precocious puberty. This is for ruling out pseudo precocious puberty, where etiology will be at the level of what we call as testes or ovary because of overproductions. So these are all the different flow charts we call. What happens to LH if LH level is low, if LH level is elevated, what way you proceed? Because if LH level is low, it can be secondary. While if LH level is high, it is usually primary etiology. So you, these are all different flow charts. At your leisure time, you can go through clinical examination followed by laboratory parameters. This is precocious puberty, how you approach to that particular person. Once you confirm the diagnosis, always treat the systemic disease. Psychotherapy is very useful to promote puberty and growth development. Low dose of testosterone and we call as estrogens in female. Psychological treatment, or we call psychotherapy and reassurance, is absolutely necessary. You can divide into functional and permanent. In a functional, chronic disease, treat the underlying cause. And if there is a severe deficiency, you can go for testosterone and estrogen therapy. If there is a constitutional etiology, observe. Some person may require testosterone therapy. In a permanent group, hypogonadotropic or hypergonadotropic. Hypogonadotropic is usually because of damage to hypothalamus or pituitary gland, where you will have to replace testosterone with estrogen and progesterone and treat the underlying cause if it is treatable. In hypergonadotropic, it is because of a primary failure of testes or ovary. In a male, mainly you will replace testosterone. In a female, you will replace estrogen, progesterone. You might require a combination therapy in some of the cases. These medicines are available in the form of an oral tablet, which you can give sublingual, or in the form of a patch, etc. As far as complication is concerned, there are mainly complication in the form of infertility, development of secondary sex characters, particularly in a person with a hermaphrodites, there will be problem with fertility. Those particular will be the common complication, or there may be complications secondary due to, we call primary etiology, like tumors, pituitary tumors, hypothalamic tumors, etc. So here I will end my lecture. I hope this will be helpful to you. You might come across sometime in your everyday practice the person with a delayed puberty or a precocious puberty, or person might come to you with a pseudo precocious puberty, all those different types of abnormalities.